We just thank God for being in his presence on today, because somebody somewhere didn't make it. Amen. But thank God we're here on today, and we just want to say, Lord, we thank you. Amen. Give God praise, y'all. Father God, we just come before you. We bow before you right now, Lord God, in your presence, just to say thank you.
Thank you.
Lord, we thank you for your love, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for allowing us to see another week, Lord God.
Thank you.
Lord God, you brought us from one Sunday to another, Lord God. Lord God, with no hurt, harm, or danger to come before us, Lord God. Lord God, you held back the hands of the death angels, Lord
thank
God.
Thank you, God.
You let no death angel come to our dwellings on last night, Lord God. Lord God, you kept the robbers, the cutthroats, the one to seek, kill, steal, and destroy away from our home, Lord God. And we say thank you.
Thank you.
Lord God, we thank you because you gave us health and strength. You gave us breath in our body, Lord God, to get up and dress ourselves, Lord God.
Thank you.
Nobody had to feed us. Nobody had to dress us, Lord God. But we could do it on our own, Lord God. And Father God, we want to thank you, Lord God, for the set man and woman of this house, Lord God. Pastor Marvin and Pastor Yolanda Harrell, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for them saying yes to you, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, Lord God, you're so awesome. We thank you for Pastor Mike and Pastor Tink. We thank you for all the elders and all the members in their rightful places on today, Lord God. Father, you're so awesome. You're wonderful. You're magnificent.
Yes, you are.
You're amazing, God.
Thank you, God.
We thank you, Lord God. Lord God, we could do nothing without you, Lord God.
Thank you, Lord.
But with you, Lord God, all things are possible, Lord God. If only we believe, Lord God. We have to believe that all things are possible. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we just thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Lord God, we thank you. Our children, Lord God. We didn't get a phone call saying our children was locked up, Lord God. We didn't get a phone call saying our children was dead, was in an accident. Oh God, we thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. You. You're wonderful. You're magnificent. You're marvelous. Lord God, we thank you for what you have. We thank you. Lord God, we thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you, God.
Thank you. You're worthy, Lord.
Yes, you are.
You're worthy, Lord. You're worthy of all the praises, Lord God. You're worthy, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus. We worship you, Lord God. Oh, God. Thank you, Lord God.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you. It's a privilege and an honor to stand before you, Lord, today. Pastor Martin, Pastor Yolanda, thank you for giving me the opportunity to stand with you for today. I was a little nervous all week. I was jumping in and out of my shoes all week. But I know God got it. It's not about me, but it's all about Him.
Amen.
And I say, God, if you put it in me, I'll bring it out.
Thank you.
If you put it in me, I'll bring it out. Whatever you want me to say, how you want me to say it, I'll do it. I'll do your will. And I say, thank you. But this morning, we have some things going on, and I'm getting ready to do a skit on this morning. And I want everybody to sit back and enjoy it, and popcorn. I have to find Joanne so she can get us a popcorn. So I want to know, Pastor, if you have anything you want to say before we start it. And I just want to thank all the visitors for coming out on today. Thank the members for being here. And thank God for the visitors that came out. And you guys just keep coming, because this man right here have an awesome word in his mouth from the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Now, how many are glad just to be here this morning?
Amen.
She already said it. How many are glad you didn't wake up on my bed pan this morning?
Yes.
You can see it. You can see it. Jesse's going to bring the popcorn in just a minute. You got a popcorn, yes, Brother Jesse? He stuck his finger up. He's going to get one bag and try to share it with everybody. It ain't going to work. It's great this morning to be in the house of the Lord. And God is good. And we just want to praise God this morning. Now, how many believe God has something for you?
Amen.
Well, that's sounding. We're going to get there. believe God's got something for you?
Yeah.
Well, we all confess, number two. Now, if you really believe that God has something for you, just lift your voice and say, God, I thank you for what you're doing. Lord, help me.
Thank you, Lord.
One day I'm going to get it. And God said this. And he, I'm pretty sure he told you. He said, you hear him. Then Jesus said to the Holy Ghost, can you hear him? Is he saying anything? Because if he's saying anything, I can't really identify what he's saying. But when you come before the Lord and say, God, here I am. Wretched man as I am. But I give you glory, God. I come before you this morning because I know you're changing me. And giving me something that I ain't never had before.
Amen.
How many believe that?
Amen.
Come on now, that's power in your sound. That's power in your praise. I tell you all the time, sometimes you can pray that that's wonderful. You can believe that's wonderful. You can receive that's wonderful. But sometimes you got to praise yourself too.
Yeah.
You got to praise yourself too this time. Right? And sometimes, let me tell you something. If you're down in your spirit, call somebody. We ain't talking about the phone, we're talking about call somebody that can pray with you and lift your spirit this morning. That can come in agreement with you and do something to help you. How many believe that this morning? Now put your hands together and give my God a hand clap. Because there's more in here than our people's lives. The presence of you this morning can touch your life and make you something you ain't never been. Listen. People are telling you all the time, you one day you're going to do it. But I'm telling you, I come to tell you, the kingdom of God says I already got it. Here we go again. It's this thing right here. This thing right here will tell you all kinds of things. But let me tell you what it'll do. It'll mess you up. In Jesus' name. Now we're going to try to, you go ahead. Praise God. Give God a hand clap.
I am doing a talk one this morning, and it's about a young lady that was on a job for 32 years, had never been late, Christian woman, never been late, more time, loving God, and one day a young lady came into the cafeteria where she was sitting. And she was telling her about some things she was going through, how her husband was abusive. He was verbal, spiritually, mentally abusive. So we're sitting talking, and I said to her, I said, well, did he hit you? And she said, no. She said, he's not physically abusive. I said, well, if he's spiritual, mentally abusive, then that's physical. Because anything that messes with your mind and your heart is physical, whether we know it or not. So we sat and we talked, and we would talk every day. We would sit in the cafeteria and we would talk. And one day she came in and she said to me, she said, you know, I'm really tired of my husband. I'm going to really miss him. And I turned my head and the Lord told me, say, tell her this. Trust me when you can't trace me. Fear not, I got your back. So I turned to her and I said, the Lord said to tell you, trust him when you can't trace him, but fear not, he got your back. So she said, you just don't know what I'm going through at home. I said, but God said to trust him when you can't trace him. So we sat and we talked, and we would come to lunch and we would talk, and she would come and she would tell me things about what she was going through and how she was going through certain things at home. And I would sit and I would talk with her. I would spiritually give her spiritual advice. And so one day I came in and I was in the cafeteria and I was eating and I didn't see my friend. And I said, oh, God, I said, well, she must be off work today. And on my way out of the cafeteria, I saw her and she said, you know, they changed our schedule. We can't eat together anymore. And I said, really? She said, no, we can't have lunch together anymore. So I said, okay. So we go into the bathroom and we're talking. And it's a lady that's there that has been sitting beside us in the cafeteria all the time. And she was in the bathroom, so she was saying, you know, she said, every time I see you, you're so happy. She said, you're never sad, you're always jolly and happy. I said, well, don't think for 1 minute that I'm always happy. I said, but I remember God's word. This is the day that God has made. I will rejoice and be glad in spite of. So we stand and we talking, not noticing that the lady that sits in the cafeteria was in the bathroom with us. So we no longer have lunch together. So one day she comes in and she texts me and she said, I need a word. And I said, well, God told me, and I text her back, I said, God told me to tell you, trace him. Trust him when you can't trace him. Fear not, he got your back. So we went on a couple of days, and one day I got a call to the office, and it was my supervisor. And he said to me, he said, Ms. Clark, he said, I have some complaint about you. And I said, really? He said, yes. He said, I heard that you're pushing your religion on the people at work. And I said, no, I'm not. I said, I don't do that. I said, I know what the policy says. So he said, well, this is a verbal warning. He says, I don't want to hear it anymore. So sure, go back to my office and I do my work. And I said, God, what do I do? So the young lady, again, she, when I wait out, I meet her and not noticing that the lady is behind us. And we're going up and we're talking and I'm talking and she said, I'm tired. I can't make it. And I said, no, you can't. But we can draw things through Christ who strengthens us. So we leave and we go home. The next day, I come to work, and I was called to the office. So I'm called to the office, and my supervisor said, Ms. Clark, we're going to have to let you go today. And I said, why? He said, because you're still pushing your God on people. So I said, no, I said, but, and I got very heavy, and I got teary-eyed. And the Lord spoke and said, trust me when you can't trace me. Fear not, I got your back. And I said, Lord, I thank you. So I go to my office and I pack up everything and I leave the office and I go get in my car. So I told my supervisor, I said, thank you, sir. And I leave. And I get in my car and on my way home. And on my way home, I had to stop at the grocery store. So I stop at the store and I'm in line. And there's a lady in front of me, a couple. And I'm in line and I have my things in my cart. And she turned back and she looked at me and she told the cashier, she says, I have her order. I'll pay for that. And I said, she said. So I said, thank you. She said, don't thank me, thank God. I said, well, I thank God for you. So she pays for my order. I leave. And on my way home, I said, well, God, you know, my son is getting ready to go to college. And maybe I need some time home with him to get him ready for college. So I stopped at the gas station and I got $15 to put in my gas tank. So there's a lady in front of me at the gas station, put my $15 in, and she has $23 left on the tank. And she looked back at me and she said, can you use some more gas in your car? And I said, sure. She said, well, it's $23 left. So with the $23, they gave me a full tank. So I said, God, I thank you. I said, you told me to trust you when I can't trust you. If not, you got my back. So I fill my tank up, I go home. When I get home, my son, he comes and he gets the bags out of the door. And he looks at me, he said, Mom, he said, you look different. And I said, well, I'm the same mother that left this morning. He said, well, there's something about you that looks different. And so I got started telling him the things that I had went through the course of the day. So he said, well, sit down, I have something for you. And I sat down and he gave me a paper. and it was an eviction notice. So I said, God, what have I done? So the Lord said, trust me. When you can't trace me, fear not. I got your back. I said, God, thank you. So I got the eviction notice, and I put it on my refrigerator, and we've been everything out. And I said, okay. So my son get ready to leave for college, and he goes, and we get everything together. The next morning, we get up, and he getting ready to leave for college. And as I go putting things in his car, Rocky Mountain Utility Company was pulling up in my driveway. So I said, excuse me, sir, can I help you? He said, yes. He said, I come to turn your service off. I said, turn my service off. He said, yeah. He said, you have a back bill that haven't been paid. I said, God, what's going on? He said, didn't I tell you to trust me when you can't trust me? Fear not, I got your back. And I walked into my head, and the young gentleman said, miss, he said, I'm not going to turn your service off. He said, I'll give you 7 days. He said, on the eighth day, he said, they will tell whether your lights are on or off. He said, I'll give you 7 days to get it right. I said, God, I thank you. And you go again, blessing me. So my lights didn't get turned off. My son leaves, and he goes to college. So he's gone. I get a phone call from him later that evening. And he said, Mom, he said, I'm at school. I said, how's everything? He said, I went to the dean's office. He said, and I have to have $1,500 to take the class that I need within 7 days or they're going to put me out. I said, Lord, I will trust you when I can't trace you, because right now I can't see what's going on. He said, fear not, I got you. So everything was going to me like around in a circle. So I'm trusting God. I'm trusting God. I'm trusting God. God, I trust you. Even though I can't trace you, I trust you. Hello?
Hey girl, what you doing?
Hey, girl, I'm not doing anything. Just sitting here, me and God, having our God time.
I'm high for you, is that okay?
Good, that's good.
Okay, I'll be done with you.
Okay.
Thank you, God.
Okay. Oh, good. Let's go. tell everybody I miss them. And I'll see you. I've got my back. Okay, thank you, sis. Awesome. I'm getting money. Bills being paid. Thank you. God, I thank you. You're so worthy, Father. God? Okay. Trust him and ask God to forgive you because I forgive you.
Lord, I trust you and I'm asking you, Lord, to forgive me for what I have done. Come into my heart and save me. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Father God. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for the lady. We thank you, Lord God, for her coming to you, Lord God, asking to be saved. Thank you, Lord God, for saving her.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord, for saving her. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. Wow, God, you're awesome. Thank you.
Wow.
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Yes, may I speak to Mrs. Clark?
Mrs. Clark speaking.
Mrs. Clark, this is Mr. Miller from P&G. I'm the CEO of the company. How are you doing today?
I'm great. How are you, sir?
Good. We just had family day at our company. You know, you were there for many, many years, and it was brought to my attention that you were no longer with the company. And I was disturbed to hear about the circumstances of your termination. And I took it upon myself to look into this matter. And I'm in the HR right now, and I'm looking at your file. And I can't find any reason for your termination. And I took it upon myself also to talk to your employees that you worked with for many years. And you probably wouldn't be surprised, but you had an effect on your employees as far as the atmosphere. Everything is different. So we miss you at our company. So what I'm basically saying, I would like you to consider coming back to our company.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, that's great. And in doing so, because of the circumstances and the reason of your dismissal, we're going to offer you an immediate dollar raise.
Yes!
All right.
And after, and also in addition to that, after the first 6 months, we're going to give you an additional $1. So would that work for you?
That will work, sir.
Okay, well, we look forward to seeing you on Monday or whenever you would like to come back. Your job is available.
Amen.
And I will be there on Monday on time. Thank you, sir, so very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. But she was in a car accident, and God didn't even let one string of her hair be touched. So she changed her life around. That was a changing point in her life. And I thank God for it, because that's how we can be hurt. And I was damaged. I'll take that back. I wasn't damaged. Satan thought he was damaging me when he took my jaw. And he took everything that was coming my way. But when God says,
Trust him when you can't trace him. Fear not, he got our backs. Believe God what he said. Because God makes no mistake.
That's right.
We make mistakes, but God don't.
Yes.
And God said, trust him. Pastor Marvin and Pastor Yolanda, I thank you for trusting God. Even if there was times you couldn't even trace him, but you trusted.
Yes. Yes.
And look where you're at today. Amen. And we thank you, guys.
Thank you.
And we love you guys so much. So, here's my cast. I thank each and every one of you guys.
See, I'm learning that as I grow in God, in my job, if they just are responding the right way, because when you do that, if God goes before you, he makes the way. But see, sometimes our life seems so, it's just so many things being poured at us. It seems everything, has anybody ever felt like it's just impossible?
Yes.
Anybody ever felt like life is just impossible?
Sometimes,
you ain't gonna make it. But see, that's sometimes, you know what? We blame the devil, but see, well, sometimes God just steps back and says, I want to see how you're going to respond to this so I can move in your life and show you something and make you stronger than you've ever been before.
Amen.
Now, how many believe that this morning? Now, Praise God. Now lift your hands and say, God, I thank you.
God, thank you.
Now, we've been preaching here all the time about your mind change. We've been preaching about your position. Your condition is not your position. How many believe that?
Amen.
How many understand that? Where you are. See, I'm not hoping, even though there's hope in the Bible, I'm not hoping, which I am hoping, because I'm receiving what he's already done. He's not coming and getting on the cross anymore. He's already done what he done. He's going to do to save people.
Amen.
He's already shed the blood that he's going to shed. Amen. Anybody believe that?
Yes.
Now, we want to understand something this morning. There's a God in your life that's moving in your life. But you got to make decisions, right decisions. Last week we said the power of change. Change will never come until you make the right decision. We can sit in the house the rest of our life and nothing's going to change. You do the same thing, you get the same result. It's been scientifically proven. You do something for 21 days, you got to have it. The hardest thing I've ever tried to do, and can I be honest with you this morning, is quit Pepsi. I quit a cigarette quicker than I did a Pepsi. I quit smoking dope quicker than I did a Pepsi. That sounds crazy, don't it? I just laid it down. But that Pepsi talked to me. That Pepsi kept calling me. Said, you ain't going to drink me this morning? I get up like this. Drank a Pepsi, calm right down. So what happened was, and can I be honest with you? I've snuck back a few times and drank some. See, some of you won't admit that. Some of us go back and do things that we don't want nobody to do. Which I did. I just did it just to see was I still there. And you, can I be honest with you? It was still good. Pepsi was good. I still believe God made Pepsi. He didn't make Coca-Cola, but he made Pepsi. I believe that. Praise God. This morning is a great morning in God. How many believe that?
Amen.
How many are searching for something from God that you ain't never had before?
Amen, yes.
Four now, are you really searching this?
Yes,
morning?
God.
Hmm? Hallelujah. Now, just tell you some things this morning. I don't want to sound like I'm bragging, but I am proud of the song that's out.
Yes.
Okay, it's doing real good today. We got a phone call. It's number 78 in the nation.
Yes,
that's something. I mean, that might not be enough for you, but it is something else. And I looked at it, when I saw Vince Gill, I said, good gracious, I want to chart for Vince Gill. I'm on the charts with this guy. They called me and said, we're going to do a big article in the magazine about the church and you. That's a little powerful. Then I just got a phone call this week, I think, really making sure. They invited me to do the war show.
Right.
Can you believe that? That's kind of big, huh? There's something else they said they wanted me to do, but I can't remember what it was. But you know, all that's fine. I love all that. But see, all that's fine, but that's a byproduct of what he can do. You got to know him to get that. You just can't con this up. Because see, sometimes your blessing is going to come through relationships. Now, everybody's careful about relationships, right? Because some people will barbecue you. I got people right now in this town trying to barbecue me. But it's all right. Guess what? I'm thankful for the free advertising, so I don't have to pay for it. How many believe that? Because see, the Bible says when people do that, that's spiteful to you. If you pray, if God will say, I'll reverse it and put it back on them. Isn't that something? Now, this morning, lift your hands. God, I thank you for that this morning. I give you praise in this house that people's lives are being changed. There's ministers in here this morning. There's pastors in here this morning. There's people that can lead praise and worship in here this morning. There's all kinds of things that we can do. God, you have given each one of us gifts to prosper in the kingdom of God. We don't have to die and just go to heaven to have everything. We can have what we need on earth today because we live in the kingdom of God. And everybody in this place said amen.
Amen.
Now, my question this morning, where is the kingdom of God? It's in you.
Amen.
I have the power to speak my situations. How many believe that? Now, I asked the Lord the other day, he said this to me. He said, I'm going to give you 8 campuses. I said to the Lord, I don't even know if I like the one you gave me. Because sometimes it's this. But listen, I said, Lord, how would this happen? He said, trust me. Now, I'm going to go along with kind of what she said this morning. I can't see everything he does, but I got to trust him. What was the line you said? Trust him because of what?
Trust me when you can't trace me.
You can't trace me. Some things I can't trace.
Come on, man.
Yes, sir.
But I know it's in the DNA of God.
Got your back.
I know God has put stuff in my life. Listen, I can't, when somebody's cooking collards and neck bone, you can smell it. When somebody's cooking pork chop, potatoes, and cabbage, you can smell it. You ain't got to tell me what it is, because I can get about three or four skills. I can tell you there's a pork chop in there, there's some corn in there, and there's some potatoes in there, and I can tell you with a neck bone. Then what I want to know, where's the greasy cornbread? Because if you ain't got no greasy cornbread, you just mess it all up. You see, I might buy that cornbread. When you buy it, it kind of run out of sight in your mouth. But then you know what I'm going to do? Man, that should be good. Anybody, let me tell you something. If you country, you know what I'm talking about. Some of you are too dignified, because it's like when I went out to eat with somebody, they sat up there with a fork trying to get the chicken off the thing. And I said, look at this. I'm at TBN, they're real edible. Got the hand down on the lap, got the napkin. I'm over like this with two elbows. I done nailed one down. Y'all keep playing with that like that. I'll be eating some chicken. I be got two chicken off your plate, you won't even know what happened to it. But that's fine this morning. Now I'm gonna do that. I have never done this song in public. Go ahead, T. Pastor T, everybody put your hand together, Pastor T. Go ahead. She operates that way. Okay? You turn it up. Ready to get to it? Now this is the song they're talking about. Wait a minute. Here comes like it's running 100 miles away. There's a fine line between rock. No, that ain't the song. T, what happened?
That's what I got.
Huh?
That's the song that's on the track.
Oh, okay. Just try it again then, T. I thought that thing took off. I'm waiting for Speedy to go down. My God.
Try it again.
I don't want to take it. Let's try it again. Maybe we can slow him down. Let's pray for him. We're 33 and a half. 45. Good. Let's see what we got this morning. We might have to do that song. I can't sing that bad. That's running 100 miles an hour right there. I don't know what they're doing. I tell you about what happened. Check the speed on the thing. It's probably somebody's speed out here. You change the pitch. That's what it is. But it's all right. Now we're gonna go another route. Wow. I can't sing that fast. But anyway. Okay, go ahead, Jake. I believe you got your stuff together. Make me sound like I'm somebody. Thank you. How do we did last week? Can we just do a little bit? I sing praises. Just a little bit. How many really love God this morning?
Yeah.
Now, open your spirit up this morning to receive something from God.
Yes.
Even though you might not be able to trace him this morning, he's still God. He still understands who you are, and he understands your situation. Guess what? He's on the job. He's thankful this morning in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Come on, man. This morning is a great morning to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Now, I play this song a lot because let me tell you what it does. It's almost like a big key. It just reaches in. It kind of opens me up where I can get the Spirit of the Lord in my life this morning. Glory to God. Hallelujah. For your name. Hallelujah. It's all right. Come on. We're not in a hurry this morning. We got time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank y'all. Wow. Man. That's awesome this morning. I need to thank God for singing praises to today. Everybody in this place needs to praise God. There's something in your life you can praise Him about.
Yes.
It might not seem, see, like if you want to say the enemy's come in and trapped you, whatever, but you can praise your way out of it. Hallelujah this morning. Praise God. Now, we got all kinds of things we can say this morning, but listen to this, brother. Everybody in this place, how many believe you're anointed this morning?
Amen.
No, come on now. Really, stop and think about what I'm saying. Do you think you're anointed? Or do you hoping you're anointed? You ain't sure you're anointed? Or you don't know if you'll ever be anointed? See, I couldn't do what I do if I'm not anointed. You can't do what you do and get up in front of people and the spirit will fall if you ain't anointed. Everybody's anointed for something.
Amen.
Hallelujah. See, I'm anointed to do what God's called me to do. Listen, the doors that's open, I've been telling you about, ain't even open all the doors that He's opening. All the world is getting ready to open for you and for me and you and the church that will occupy you for the rest of your life and maintain you. Can you but listen, it's hard to see that when, listen, the anointing that's on your life will disarm the enemy. Did you hear what I said? The enemy, listen, they no doubt the enemy don't come and try to see what's on you. When he comes, he says, that guy's anointed. I can't touch him. How many believe that this morning? The anointing that's on your life will disarm the enemy when he tries to come. Sometimes the enemy don't come in a physical being. He'll come through people. And that's when he messes you up. He'll come through people and they'll try to mess you up and tell you you can never be what you need to be. And that anointing will disarm those people. How many believe that?
Amen.
Does anybody hear me this morning?
Yes.
You and I have to become partners with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Everybody in this place has to become a partner with the Holy Ghost. This is your triune being this morning. I'm going to skip around this morning. I got to find where I'm at this morning. Listen, you and I are a triune being. You have a spirit, soul, and body. When you and I was born again by the Spirit of the Lord, your spirit was made new.
Amen.
Listen, it don't make no difference what's going on. Your spirit is already what it's going to be.
Amen.
Amen. Wow. Your spirit ain't black.
Come on.
Your spirit ain't white.
Amen.
Your spirit ain't red. Your spirit's in the image of God.
That's right.
I didn't believe that this morning.
Amen.
One guy said, you got a black church and a white church. I said, no, I got a spirit church.
Oh, yeah.
You see all that. I don't see that crap. I don't see it, no. Because if you take your spirit out of your body, guess what you're going to do? You're going to fall down and shoot, going to hit the floor.
That's right.
Do you understand that this morning?
Amen.
So your anointing will disarm the enemy. Huh? Praise God. Now listen, the new birth was your spirit man. But we still have the same body and the same mindset. Everything that's happening to you, you keep blaming the devil, and the devil don't have no power over you.
Amen.
How many believe that? How many believe this? If you believe the devil got power over you, lift your hand. Because if you do, there's something wrong with you. He don't have no power because the word says he don't.
That's right.
If he does have power, or you think he's got power, it's because you're giving him that power.
Yeah.
And you're giving him that mindset to offset you in the spirit of the Lord.
Yeah.
How many believe that?
Yeah.
We have a spirit, then our mind is renewed by the word of God, and then the reality is what is on the inside of us. Who we really reality is in God.
Amen.
You understand that? There's a realness to this. I want to be a country music singer. I want to have records on chart. Came close many times. Want to do this, then God said, I want you to preach. I said, you got to be kidding me. Is this a joke? I said, listen, I'm traveling all over the country. Me and my wife in 84, I got a song with Michael Jackson. I would be like Michael. You know what I'm saying? But you know I can't do that. You know what I'm saying? I'm on front page with him. I'm on front page with Hula Clay. I said, man, this is what I'm going to be. And I said, I got something else for you to do. Well, I'm mad. Listen, I was mad for one day. I'm mad for 20 years. You think you get mad, you stay mad 2 or 3 days. Me and her get mad when, you know, get mad anymore. Do I get mad like I used to? She get more mad than me. Something wrong with that woman. I told the Lord, I said, ain't me, Lord, it's that woman you gave me. That's messing me up. Anybody got one?
Amen.
Come on now. He said, I ain't gonna raise my hand. My wife says, I mean, said she get ready to jab on me. No, I just missed it. You're all right, man. I'm just cutting up with you. Come on now. But see, all I wanted to do in life was play music and do this. But God says, no, I got a bigger plan for you. Now, guess what? Years and years and years. It didn't take me 2 years to agree with it. It didn't take me 5 years. How many years has it been? 30 years almost to agree with this thing. So it's not something just happened. That's why we're walking in the anointing that we're walking in. That's why cancer dries up when you speak to it. Huh? How many of you here believe you're really anointed to prosper? Come on now. If you believe you're anointed to prosper, split your hand. How many believe you're a failure this morning? There's no failures in the kingdom of God.
Amen.
Huh? There's people all the world who do better than I'm doing. Guess what? I don't care. I don't care what you can do better than me. I'm just doing what he told me to do. So guess what? When I bypass you, see you later, alligator. See what I'm saying? Listen, in the New Testament, 54 times in the New Testament, let's see. I'm trying to figure out what I wrote. Oh, I know what it was. In the New Testament, 54 times it talks about my mindset. In the Old Testament, it's 38 times. Altogether, it's 92 times that the Bible speaks about our mindset. He speaks about our mind more than it speaks about a devil. I'm coming against me. See, my mindset tells, listen, my mind dictates, listen, wherever my mind is, that's where I fall. How many believe that? Our marriage is not what it used to be. Our marriage is not where it was because we made a conscious decision and had to change our mindset to make this thing work. She ain't gonna do no better than me. But some of you laughing. What's she gonna go get something like this? She can go all over America. It ain't nothing like this, baby. Yeah, some of you got, listen, some of you don't feel that way about saying, because you feel like you're a loser. I ain't no loser.
Amen.
I'm in the kingdom of God. Amen. I understand who I am. I walk in authority with God. Listen, if you think I'm talking about because I look so good, I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about who I am, what he says I am.
Amen.
God don't make no ugly.
Come on,
you know. Are you ugly?
No, sir.
I didn't think you were ugly. Oh, is he handsome?
He is.
God, she said, look, she caught her leg when she said that. Is he handsome?
He is.
He is. You love him?
I love him.
Good God, I said, I'm just. Good God, I mean, y'all need room, do you? Oh, you can, okay. Oh. I got one too. But see, my friend, right here, you got to look at yourself and say, you know what? It might not be, I might not feel good today. I might not have everything I need. But God said, he's on my side. God said, the impossible will be possible with me. The impossible will never happen until you got Jesus on. You see, the reason why some of you going through what you're going through is because you don't realize what you can demand from God. Well, God says, if you ask me, I'll do it. And put a demand on his word. And God said, I'll bring it forth. See, some of us walk around like we just sissies. We don't understand who are. I got the power to tell the devil to go to hell. See, some of you say, wait, I ain't cussing. I'm trying to tell you, that's where he needs to be in hell. He don't need to be walking around here tormenting me. I need to be tormenting him. I didn't believe that today.
Amen.
Praise God. Turn your Bibles to 1 Peter. Turn your Bible. We're going to read some scripture because some people say we don't read the Bible around here. Say what? No, it won't be either. Let's just read some scripture and let's see if we make it. Listen to this right here. First Peter, the first chapter, verse 13. Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind. Did he say gird up the loins of the devil? He said gird up the loins of your mind. Do you understand what I'm saying to you this morning? Huh? It's your mind that's playing tricks on you. But the reason why it's playing tricks on you, because you have not covenanted with the Word of God and put the anointing of God on it. How many believe that this morning? Now let's gird the loins of your mind and be sober and help and to the end for grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Everybody in this place this morning needs to understand that a revelation of Jesus Christ you need in your life. You got to understand, you're covered by the blood of Jesus. How many believe you're covered by the blood of God?
Amen.
You ain't covered by Pepsi and Walmart oil. You're covered by the Master's blood. He sold himself. He died for you on the cross and gave himself so you could be who you need to be.
Amen.
Huh? That blood's powerful. That blood changes everything. Turn your Bible to Ephesians, the fourth chapter. Come on. We're going to read some scripture this morning. Come on. Ephesians, the fourth chapter. And they said, well, what is he even talking about this morning? I don't know, Mavis. Ain't no Mavis in here, is he? Praise God. Okay, the fourth chapter, 23rd verse. Now listen to this. The 23rd verse says this. And be renewed in the mind of your spirit. You got to be renewed in your mind, in the spirit of it. You understand what it said? Now listen, I'll read it again. And be renewed in the spirit of your mind. So you got to cover your mind with the Spirit of the Lord and the Word of God. The only, listen, how is anything more effective than the Word of God? I don't know what it is. That's why he gave you the Word to speak to situations in your life, to change your circumstances. There's people here this morning that's not here this morning. You know why? Because they don't have the right mindset. Their mind's all over the place. They're just running from place to place, but never settle in the kingdom of God. So God can never do nothing with you because you're just running around like in a field, running, trying to eat grass on this side of the fence, grass on that side of the fence. And guess what? You don't understand all the grass you need is right in front of you.
Amen.
So, now we'll read that again. Let's read that. Just read it one more time. Now, well, I'm going to switch over because I feel like God just impressed me. Ephesians 3:20. We know the scripture. To him that is able to to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask to think.
Yes.
There you go. There's your mind again. You got to think about this thing.
Yes.
I watch people preaching on TV every morning. I turn the TV. It's the devil. It's the devil. The devil did it. The devil stole my stuff. He stole my stuff. Well, let me tell you something. Be honest with you. Come on, man. If he stole my stuff, it must not be my stuff. And that goes against grain, don't it? It ain't my stuff. If he can take my stuff, it must have been his stuff.
That's right.
Because you can't take my stuff if I got a Holy Ghost God.
Amen. Amen. Come on.
You understand that? Because see, religious people will always be religious.
Right.
It's like a Sadducee. It's so sad that you see.
Oh, I gotta skip for that.
Yeah, listen, you're a Sadducee. It's so sad that you see. Because now you can't see because you're a Sadducee. That sounds crazy, but listen, that's really something to that. They came to God and said, why do you heal on the seventh day? He said, because you don't know who I am. Because your religion told you I can't do this. But you don't understand, I can do anything because I own that day.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, that's a power word right there. You need to know that in God you can own your day.
Amen.
Bashuku Makasta, in Jesus' name. So if you want to be a Sadducee and be some Sadducee, that's all you're ever going to be. I choose not to do that. People said, I asked some people last week, I said, did you get up? What did you get up this morning? This is what they said. I got up. I just got up. I said, that's all you did? Just got up? You didn't get up? I got up in the Holy Ghost. I got up in God. I didn't get up in the devil. When you tell them that, they nailed you. They're trying to find, listen, then what they do, they'll come against you and tell you why you can't be what you need to be. Because they're coming with you with religious and a religious mindset. Our mind has to be renewed by the word of God.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
How does the enemy have so much power over you?
He don't.
Huh? Say it again. Who said that?
He don't.
He don't. We're there. When we made a conscious decision, we fought for 25 years. We're the only one in here now. So I know we ain't talking about the others. We had it. You did it. Yeah, but see, when we had a conscious decision, the conscious decision to change, God anointed our marriage to be different. See, sometimes you got to go before the Lord. And listen, there's nothing wrong with bowing yourself and lifting your hands to God. I come before you because I messed up.
Yes.
See, some people can't do that because you're so afraid somebody's going to see you. I don't care if you see me.
Come on now. That's right.
You don't care what they did.
That's right.
You got to understand, when I come before the Lord, there ain't nobody but me and him and Harry. I don't care. I'm anointed for this.
Yes, God.
You can stand there and look at me and tell me all my fault. You know, I don't hear you. What are you saying, Lord? You can do it, buddy. Some of you, that's why you don't do right. We can't do right because you care about what people think. I don't care.
Exactly.
I can care less.
Amen.
Is that wrong?
No.
Amen.
People talking about me all over Rocky Mountain. I don't care. It ain't gonna change what he's doing for me because he's growing me.
Amen.
I know who he is. I'm walking in a different note. Guess what? The note I walk in more is gonna be stronger today.
That's right.
Huh? That's why cancer can't. Listen, cancer has a voice. That's why my voice has got to be stronger than cancer's voice. That's why diabetes. You got your voice of God has got to be stronger than diabetes.
Amen.
My God. My God.
Does anybody believe that today?
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you a question. What voice are you using? Why ain't your voice dictating your life, dear?
That's right.
Why ain't it changing your circumstances? It must be something lacking. Listen, everybody has problems. Let's get it straight.
Yeah.
Let's get in the wisdom of God. Does that make sense? Do I sound crazy this morning? If I can stop. It's like I told this lady right here, I cannot remember your name, woman. Miss Alice goes all over America. All over the world. She evangelizes, right? The anointing that's on your life, the devil's scared of it. Huh? How long have you been serving Jesus? 64 years. I ain't 60 years old. She was serving Jesus 4 years before my mom and daddy got together. I sat here ministering, listen. Do you know what? Listen, let me tell you something. Don't ever count the saints that's been with God for a long time. Because they got equity, Bill, that you ain't got.
That's right, man.
Listen. Lord, show me. Listen, I can already tell in your hand, you can knock hell loose. Huh? When you walk in the room and start laying here, I can already hear you in working before God. And when you lay your hand, then God says, listen, I gotta come because she's been doing this for 64 years.
Thank you.
I said, I asked him one time, why my headaches don't leave when I pray? And Sister Moore prayed, she 80 some years old. He said, because you ain't got nothing, she got it all. I said, well, where do I get it? He said, you're gonna build some equity, but you ain't got nothing right now. Well, she called me, I come immediately.
Amen. Amen.
That's the difference. See, let me tell you something. If you think you're not, how anointed do you think you are today? Are you anointed?
Yes, sir.
How about 10 years from now? How long are you going to be? Sure. Wow, that's a good word. How about 10 more years from now? You're going to be over. You ain't even going to be able to carry. You're going to have to get you another truck. You got to get your trailer to pull the anointing from your life. Because the enemy sees that. That's why the enemy comes against you sometimes. Because he's trying to say, if I can stop him now, he won't do nothing later. They see it. Let me tell you something. I ain't never said there were no devil. I just said he ain't got no power over me. I ain't never said there were no devils. Demons.
Amen.
But there, where that? Under my foot.
That's right. Amen.
A lot of people, guess where you got it? In your pocket. You take him out when you need it. Because you want to show everybody why you can't be what you are. So I'm going to take this devil out. Can you identify with this devil in my pocket? Because when I take this out, then I got an excuse why I can't be what I need to be. Because I got to get up off my blessed assurance and make a change.
Amen.
Huh? Anybody believe that?
Amen.
You look around today, TVs, all kinds of stuff here. You think this is it?
Nope.
This is just the beginning. I'm anointed for more than this. Guess what? You are too.
That's right.
It just so happened that good looks come in. I'm sorry. See, somebody got to laugh. Everybody just back. Is anybody back? Feel like you're back? Laugh, please laugh. Come on. You got to be free in this. You see what I'm saying? Okay, turn your Bibles to Philippians 2:5. Come on, somebody read it. Anybody got Philippians 2:5? I had it, but I don't know what we did with it. My Bible was tore all up this morning. I think it's because I thought it so much. Anybody else thought your Bible? Come on now, you come on now. Anybody ever cuss while you had a Bible in your hand? Listen, I bet, boy, I get going in. Anybody else said something you ain't supposed to say? You just got through speaking in tongues? Come on, man. Come on, let's get real with it. Huh? Who's got 2:5 this morning? Can you read it this morning?
It reads, "Let this man be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus."
Wow, read that again. Just read it real slow. That'll sink in this morning.
"Let this man be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus."
See? "Let this mind be in you, which is Christ Jesus." Why is it God always talks about your mind? Listen, when Jesus was in the garden, who was he attacked? In his mind. See, you think he overcome at the cross. He overcame in the garden. That's where he sold out to him.
That's right.
That's why, listen, when you see blood sweat out of my head, you better check me. Well, I know I'm getting ready. I don't know what getting ready to happen. When I go through going where I'm praying and then my sweat becomes blood, you better know something. I know what I'm gonna do. You know something? Now turn your Bible to James 5 of chapter 1. Huh? We'll just read scripture along this morning. I want to tell you who you are this morning. Okay, now let's go to number 8. Listen to this right here. James 1 and 8 says this: "A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways."
All his ways.
Now, it didn't say he's unstable in a double.
All his ways.
In his ways. In his mindset.
Amen.
That's right.
Listen, we've been taught all our life. Listen to this. Anybody not agree with you? The Bible says, "If I put my hands to the plow and look back, I ain't fit for the kingdom of God." Did it say that?
Yeah.
But did it say I'm going to heaven?
That's right.
See, I was telling sis this morning, listen, we get heaven and the kingdom of God mixed up.
That's right.
It's two different things. It's two different entities.
That's right.
But when we put them together, we all messed up. The kingdom of heaven, listen, you ain't got to go to die and go to heaven to have heaven in your life. You can have it now.
That's right.
Heaven's here. The kingdom of God's in here.
Yeah, that's right.
Come on.
Huh? I don't need money in heaven. Because I don't need it there, but I need some here.
Right.
I don't need a good marriage there, I need it here. I need good kids, not crazy kids, I need it here.
Amen.
I need to have whatever I need to save my life here, not over there.
Amen.
Go to the grocery store and tell that woman you want to buy groceries, speak in tongues, see what they tell you. He going to say, that's wonderful, I like that. Sounds great, what you have you got any money? Because we won't see the money. Okay, now turn your Bible to 2 Corinthians 5:7 then. Come on. I know you probably said, well, he's crazy this morning. He ain't. Second Corinthians 5:7. No, 17, sorry. 17.
5:17.
Yeah, 5:17. listen to this right here. I'm trying to read this statement. For the flesh lusts against the spirit. Everything that's in your carnal mind is against God, in the image of God. It don't want God. Listen, your mind without God don't want God. Because it don't know God. It wants everything off the flesh stuff. Anybody know what the flesh stuff is? We ain't talking about just drinking, smoking dope, and we doing this and doing it, running around doing it. There's a lot of things that a lot of people do, you don't know they do it. Huh? Now listen to this. We're going to read this again. For the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. Listen, there's always a battle of flesh against the spirit, spirit against the flesh. Because your spirit, listen, your spirit knows God. It knows what's right. It knows what's wrong. Huh? Now listen to this. And these are contrary to one another, which it tells you it is. So they work against each other. So that ye cannot do the things that ye would. The reason why a lot of us don't do the things that God wants us to do, our mind has tricked us. It's told us that we can never be, or if something's coming in our life, past hurts. You know the biggest thing that can hurt you is unforgiveness. Yeah. It'll kill you. It'll make you sick in your body.
Amen. That's right.
There's people that I don't have. Let me tell you, I just don't deal with you. You ain't in my vicinity. I'm like Pastor Phil. I choose not to participate. Do whatever you want to do. Stand on the mountain and shout. Now, I don't care. I'm going to be going. I'm not Speedy Gonzales. Yep, I'm going. You ain't going to touch me. Because you're not going to mess my spirit up. Huh? How many believe that now? 5:17. Let's read it again. The flesh, for the flesh lusteth against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are the contrary to one another, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. But if ye, listen, but if ye be led of the Spirit, ye, and not of the law. God is a Spirit God. He leads us in the Spirit. How many believe that today? Can anybody understand what I'm telling you today? Huh? Lift your hands right now. Let God say, God, I know you know me. And I thank you for the Spirit that's in my life. And I receive the presence of the Spirit to change me. Everybody say amen. Huh? Praise God this morning. Now listen to this. We have to have a standard of truth. This standard is based on certain. Most people base your, listen, you base your truth on these things. Circumstances. Feelings. Emotions, conditions, and atmosphere that's around you. If you get yourself in all of that, you won't never know God. You won't never feel His presence. How many like feeling the presence of God?
Amen.
Has anybody ever felt the true presence of God?
Okay.
Praise God. And so we come on Sunday morning to tell you who you can be. Listen, but Monday comes. See, you got to have God by yourself on Monday. Because this building ain't open. See, when we shout together, you don't know what nobody got. We all shout, well, he got it. But when you walk out that door come Monday morning, that's when you better know when the rubber meets the highway what you got in Jesus.
That's right.
You better understand that.
That's
because
right.
The enemy, listen, I never said there won't be any. I just said he ain't got no power.
Amen.
So what do we do in some of the countries she goes in where there ain't nothing but God? No doctors, no medicine. People dying, people hungry, right? They ain't got but one thing to depend on, the Spirit of the Lord and the Holy Ghost. The reason why we don't do that is because we've been modernized. We've had it too good. Because see, we can leave right today and go and sit down in a restaurant and eat a nice meal. When these people over here can't even get a glass of water.
Amen.
But the problem with that is, that don't bother you.
Well.
But it bothered me.
Yes, sir.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Listen to this. The standard that you and I need to cling to is the Word of God. How many believe in the standard of God? How many believe that? Now listen to the perception of my life. How many have a perception of things? Now listen, the perception of my life determines how I will be and where I will go in God. I see myself prosperous.
Amen.
People ask me all the time. They might think I'm arrogant. I don't care. I can't fail.
That's right.
Come on.
That sounds bad, don't it? So some people say, man, I don't like that. That sounds arrogant. I don't care. The Bible says I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
That's right.
He didn't say you're going to be a loser the rest of your life. See, I should come up here, and I did it a few weeks ago. What I should have done, let me tell you, I've been lying to you guys. Because let me tell you something. The devil's always going to beat you. He ain't never going to have nothing. And all you ever going to be is a get back. Now, let me tell you, now we can shout over that, and we'll have the money, buddy. They'll be shouting. They believe that. For the devil. Huh? And one morning I said, turn your Bibles to the book of opinion, and there was changes all over the church shifting. Y'all believe that's a book of opinion? Are you kidding me?
No.
Huh? But I should come and tell me, told you a lie. You ain't never going to be nothing. That word's a lie. You'd be surprised at me if people believe that. They understand that, but then you come and tell them, there ain't no weapon formed against you going to prosper. I know who I am in God. Because see, I'm talking like my Father. I'm talking like the Spirit of the Lord. No weapon formed against me can fight, can even gather around me because he's powerful in my life.
Amen.
Do you understand that? Wow. Everybody ought to try this. You need to come try. You need a good dose of this.